Jack Darlington has been in touch to ask us for some advice on painting freehand designs on banners. So today we're going to give you some great tips and tricks of doing that by painting the design of Hallow Heart on a Free Guild soldier's banner, who you can see I've got ready just here, and I've undercoated him with a McCrag blue spray as well, which is the starting colour for this banner. And when you're doing freehand designs, there's a couple of things to bear in mind to make the process easier, and the first is that you should use an appropriate brush. For this, I'm going to be using an Artificer layer brush, and I recommend you do the same for fine detail work such as this. Now the first colour we need is Celestra Grey, and this is to base coat the gem in the middle of the banner, and then we need McCrag Blue, and this is to add some detail to the gem and also to neaten it up as well. After that we'll need Avalan Sunset for the yellow designs above and below it, and then once more we'll use McCrag Blue to add detail to this and again neaten it up. But we're going to start with Celestra Grey using a small Artificer layer brush, and there's another thing to bear in mind here when you're doing freehand designs, and that is when you get your paint ready on the palette, you should thin it down more than you normally would. So you want to bring it down to around about this point here. You can see it's quite runny. The reason for it is I need it to flow very easily from the brush because I need that control over it. But you mustn't overload your brush because you don't want the paint to go running everywhere when you start to apply it. So you just need to make sure you got it down to about this point. Just twist your brush to bring the bristles to a nice tip, and then on the banner, start looking to make the design out of basic shapes. The first step for doing this is to start in the very middle, and I'm just going to paint a little dot in the center there like that. And then from that point on, what I'm going to do is paint a central line for our gem. And it's just going to run down here like this, and I want to get a roughly equal amount of blue above and below it up to the edge of the banner. So around about there like that. So it's just a guideline really. After that, I need to turn it into a cross to get the basic shape for the gem. So around about there like that. And from this point on, it's just a matter of connecting the edges, so from here down to the bottom, like this, and then as you go, just fill in the middle. Now, as you can see, the colour's quite thin, so I recommend applying two thin coats here before you move on to the next step. Once you're happy with that diamond shape, you're then ready to move on to McCrag Blue. Now there's two main steps for this. First of all, what you should do is use this colour to neaten up any little parts we've gone over around the edges, such as just down there and then just up here as well. And also you can use this for slight adjustments on the overall shape of it as well. But then what you're ready to do is start painting the detail onto it. Now for this, you need to look at that midpoint there, those two dots. Slightly below it, we want to paint a line just going across. So around about there, like that. And then once we've got that established, we can use it to start drawing lines connecting to all the edges. So we want to go up to about there, like that, and out to the outside edge, like this, and it's just a matter of working your way around. Now, should you make any mistakes, just go back to Celestra Grey to neaten up before you continue. Now that we've finished painting in our gem, we're ready to add the yellow designs around it, and for this we need Avalan Sunset. Now, for the one underneath, what you do is start out with a line going down the middle, like that, straight down, and then we need to add one to the side around about here. And then another one around about here. From this point, we can work out the core design of the part underneath by a semicircle, just connecting all three like this. And it's just a matter of gradually widening out this pattern to get our design. You can also add in the extra two lines, so we need to have one going out that direction and one going out in this direction. So there we go. Now for the top, we need the flames on it. And for this, just start out by painting a line, just running down either side of the gem. So I'll start on this one, going down roughly like that. And this is our baseline for the fire. The actual fire itself is quite simple. All you've got to do is paint just a wiggly line going up to a point. So I'm just going to bring it down to around about there, and then connect it on the other side as well. And then it's just a matter of essentially colouring this in. And finally, we're ready to return to McCrag Blue once more to finish off the yellow details. So again, we can neaten them up by just cutting into them ever so slightly like this to sharpen up designs just down here and make these arrows a little bit narrower like that. But also we can use this point just to add a few little extra details too, such as the little dots that we've got in this part down here. And there we are, the Hallow Heart banner design is complete. So remember, when you're doing freehand designs like this, you can make it easier for yourself by starting out with simple shapes located so that you can get the design where you exactly you want it to be, and then just take your time adding extra detail to it and neatening up as you go. So John, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.